We're going to see how the Kofax AP Automation Solution can automate capture and provide extensible best practice workflows for invoice processing, approvals, and ERP integration. Here you can see the different members of the accounts processing department. Claudia handles the incoming invoices and data entry. Giovanni is her supervisor and handles out-of-order invoices, and Giovanni approves low-cost invoices. Claudia is an accounts payable user. She's received some invoices through the mail and wants to scan them with her desktop scanner. Claudia puts her invoices into her scanner and presses the scan button in her browser. The invoices appear on her screen. Upside-down pages have been automatically rotated, blank pages have been deleted, and all images are crisp and readable black and white. She can review and rearrange them if she likes before submitting them. She could also load files from her desktop, submit them via an MFP device. They can even be automatically processed from email attachments or from incoming faxes. Andrew's task is to apply GL coding to invoices. He sees invoices waiting for him on his task list. Andrew sees instructions on what he needs to do for this invoice. Andrew can review the invoice details and apply GL coding to each of the invoice line items. He's provided with lists of GL coding templates, as well as a list of frequently and recently used codes. He can also look up GL codes using a form that pulls account information from the ERP system. Once the correct codes have been selected, they can be applied to the invoice line items. Andrew completes the GL coding, presses Done, and the invoice is on its way again to the next task, approval by the purchaser, Giovanni. Claudia will not see many of these invoices again. PO invoices that are in good order and match with a PO in the ERP system will go straight through for payment. Non-PO invoices that are in good order will be presented to the purchaser for GL coding and will then go through an approval process. Claudia or another colleague will only have to deal with invoices that are unclear, not machine readable, or not in good order. They will appear automatically in her work queue, waiting for her corrections and validation. Let's now look at how Giovanni can approve an invoice on his mobile phone. Giovanni has received an email notification requesting him to approve an invoice. Giovanni taps the link. Giovanni can now review the invoice details and view an image of the invoice. He can now click on the Approve button to approve the invoice. Now we'll see how an approver can approve an invoice from within the system. We'll log in as Giovanni and complete the approval by selecting the task from the task list. The invoice will now be sent for payment in the ERP system if no further approvals are required. Invoices can have problems that automation cannot handle alone. They may be machine unreadable, unclear, or not in good order because of missing information or other errors. Here, Claudia can take corrective action. Claudia sees invoices waiting for her to validate in her task queue. Claudia can see the invoice and all of the fields that have been extracted. Fields containing errors are marked in red and have an error message. Claudia can type to enter data from the document using autocomplete or by clicking on the document. This helps the system learn about these invoices for the next time, reducing her effort. Claudia's attention is drawn to the line items that failed to automatically match the purchase order in the ERP system. Claudia can correct matching errors, and when the data is validated against business rules, she can submit the invoice for the next step. Now, let's have a look at how members of the accounts payable team can gain insight into system and user performance and statistics using the system's analytics functionality. System analytics are presented as a series of dashboards. The first category of dashboards is improving productivity. The Invoice Activity Profile dashboard gives a view of live invoices and their status, broken down by resource name. This allows the user to hover over the bars on the dashboard and see the resource assignment for each group of invoices. The user can click on the dashboard to interactively filter the other dashboards in the view. The Throughput Status dashboard gives a view of volumes of invoices that are in progress versus those that have completed processing. The next dashboard section is called Paying Invoices. This gives the accounts payable team a view of the payment status of the invoices that are currently live in the system, including a detail view at the bottom of the form. The user can filter the detail view by clicking on the dashboards above. The Invoice Payment Status dashboard shows the payment status of live invoices, whether they are due, paid, or past due. This gives the accounts payable department visibility of invoices that are missing their SLAs and could potentially be costing the organization extra money. The Invoices Coming Due dashboard gives a breakdown of live invoices by the number of days until their due date. This gives the accounts payable department visibility of invoices that are approaching their SLAs and enables them to effectively manage the work within the system. The next dashboard category is Managing Cash. This relates to early payment discounts that the organization could potentially be taking advantage of. The Invoice Discount Status dashboard gives a view of discounts for which the organization is potentially eligible, as well as those that have been taken or lost. The Invoices Days Till Due dashboard gives a breakdown of invoices that have an eligible discount by the number of days until they become due. Below are views that show the numbers of invoices above and below the high-value threshold for each business unit. The next dashboard category is Removing Bottlenecks. This relates to outstanding actions on invoices within the system. Invoices that have been routed for comment to purchasing or for supplier maintenance and have outstanding actions will be included in this view. This gives the accounts payable team visibility of invoices that are held up or are causing bottlenecks within the system. The user can filter the detail view at the bottom by clicking on the dashboard above. The next dashboard section is called Managing Suppliers. This gives a drill-down view by year and month of discounts that have been taken and the suppliers that they relate to. We also get a view of the average time that has been spent on an invoice in minutes. This gives the accounts payable department visibility into which suppliers are taking the longest to process per invoice. The next section is called Compliance. This gives the accounts payable team visibility of potential duplicate invoices that could be paid multiple times, costing the organization money. The Total Agility Analytics dashboards enable us to gain insight into document-related activity within the system. The Overview dashboards give a view of statistics related to live activity. The Current Activity view shows the volume and Giovanni's pending time for each activity type. The Completed Activity History by Type dashboard shows the number of activities completed each day, broken down by activity type. Hovering over the graph shows the activity type for each block of activities. The Finished Jobs by Process Type dashboard shows how many jobs of each process type have completed within a specific time period. In order to get a view of time spent on different activities by different operators, we can look at the Time dashboards. The top three operators with the shortest and longest time give us visibility of either end of the performance spectrum. Below, we have a breakdown of activities completed in the last 10 days. We also have a drill-down view showing activity type broken down by operator and showing the total time each operator has spent on each activity type. The cost view shows a breakdown of activity type by cost. We can see that manual activities are currently costing the most to process. The Total Operation Costs dashboard shows us a view of the total cost for processing each activity type within a given time frame. The cost per hour shows us how much each activity type is costing per hour. We can see that validation and manual activities are costing the most to process. We also have dashboards based on document classification and data extraction. We can see a breakdown of the percentage of each document field that has been changed. This gives us insight into how accurate our extraction is. The global reach and financial success of Kofax makes us a trusted partner of many. With more than 1,200 employees in 37 countries, a strong base of channel partners, and a strong financial position, we have more than 20,000 customers worldwide. Our accounts payable track record includes more than 400 years of professional services team experience implementing AP automation solutions and multiple successful ERP and other system integrations. Thank you for taking the time to view our AP solution overview. For additional information, please visit our website at www.kofax.com/AP.